Howdy folks, today I'm going to change your way of changing transmission mounts by teaching you how to do it without dropping the crossmember. Now besides the transmission mount, all you need is a basic assortment of wrenches, normally 18 or 19 millimeter, a jack, I prefer at least a 3-ton, and some wood. If you find you got a skid plate in the way, you just need to remove it with some 10 millimeter sockets. Pretty easy to find where the transmission mount is, it's on the transmission. Funny they called it that. Cannot use compressed air here. You'll just rip it out and they'll spin, and then you'll be in a world of hurt. Sometimes breaking off the 19 millimeter bolt that connects the mount to the transmission can be a real pain because you don't really have a lot of clearance in here to be swinging around with a traditional breaker bar. But what you can do is you can snake a wrench up and get on it. But what you may find is that it's too tight for you to move. So I'm gonna teach you an old trick. Sometimes the only thing that can get in there is just a regular old box wrench. But what can happen is you can get on a fastener that's so tight, you can't break it free. And that's because the lever is what pushes down the mechanical force on the fastener. Well, if you run out of lever, an old trick that I learned, that some guy learned off some other guy that probably learned in the original Model T factory is, you can lock two of these wrenches together, and now you have a very long lever in order to put lots and lots of force on your stuck fastener. Back to the subject at hand, remove the two 19 millimeter bolts from the transmission mount. Stick the jack up under the truck. Your goal here is to get the piece of wood up on the transmission pan so that you don't have the metal biting into metal, but it pads it as we jack and lift out the transmission. And see, it comes off the mount, and we can just wiggle that sucker out there. It's gonna move a bit and take up some of the play, but you won't hurt anything. The transmission mount isn't connected to the transmission, it just pulls right out. And look at that, we didn't even have to drop the transmission crossmember. After a bit of finagling, I couldn't do it one-handed. The new transmission mount just slides into place where the old one was. You may find as you try to put the two 19mm bolts back in that the holes don't quite line up. Don't be afraid to grab her and give her a little bit of a shift one way or the other. Just take a little bit of weight off the transmission so you're free to move it. And you could also give a little bit of wiggle to the mount. As long as you got this transmission in here and your hands out in a way that they can get pushed out, you're safe. Don't stick your hands up in between heavy things and metal things. That's not smart. Don't do it. No. And I mean you. Once you have the 19s on nice and tight, you can drop the jack down. And then all we gotta do is put those 18s back on, reattach the skid plate, and we're done.